Hello, everyone, and welcome back to some Deadly Premonition. Like I was just telling the people in chat, I probably will be cutting this short, so it'll be a four-episode week. I mean, it's better than nothing. Oh, shit. Yeah, anyway. That happened on stream and on YouTube. Great. I have no idea why that foamed up on me so bad. All right, well. Regardless, Jesus. Probably going to be the last thing. It's going to be a four-episode week. I'm tired. My abs hurt from working out. So sitting up, not exactly the most comfortable thing. Blah, blah, blah. Let's just get into it. Pisses me off a little bit.
Okay, then, Zach. Let's pay Harry another visit and get to the bottom of all this.
I mean, unless this wraps up.
I do like spending a bit of time investigating alone. I'm getting a bit sick of being told that I'm either too slow or too fast. You agree with me, right, Zach?
Sure. Sorry. I was just... I happen to have Twitch up, and it just got to the... Yeah. Yeah. Anyway. I mean, to be fair, like, this game has a really cool thing about having it have a persistent world. Like, I like, yeah, I wanted to see how, if it, like, showed how bad it was. Apparently, when I went to go, it was off camera, so none of you saw how bad foamed up. I think I fucked. I mean, it's still kind of in front of me, so... Great.
No, nothing. Just my imagination.
Hmm. Alright. Time to drive on the tracks, because I don't have anywhere else to go. Here. Yep, I did. Beato, 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 beato.
Mr. Francis York Morgan, finally you have arrived. You are welcome to come inside.
Looks like the next game is hide and seek. Huh?
Fucking great. Do I need to eat or anything? Nah, I'm good. That was cool. There's only three of them. I'll very much take that. Looks like the door wasn't locked. No. I'm gonna go check the other way first. Not after that growl that I just heard. Let's see, so that's where I came out. God, that's such a gross looking sandwich. What's in here? Is it a save point? It's a save point. A weird spot to have that, but all right. Great aim. First aid. No. I don't want your fist in my mouth. This thing up first. I'm glad the audio cut out there. Fuck. Oh, are you fucking serious? Okay. So nothing that way. Can't go that way. That's where I just came from. We have this again. Yep. Nope, I get stuck on there, so. Nope. That took a lot. Hi. Pull to me right now.
Let me go. Let me go.
We're out of bullets now, yep. Out of bullets with that.
Great. Great.
way is better? The other way is gonna get first.
Emily!
At times we must because they should not exist, even if it means losing someone that you love.
Stop!
Okay. Mr. Stewart?
Zach. Looks like we're out of the countryside and back in civilization.
Welcome, York.
I brought the documents.
Just what is going on in here?
Take it slow. You'll lose sight of what's important if you just rush past it. As an agent of the FBI, I'm sure you know. So many people have got it all wrong. They think speed is the key. That being first is the best. They want speed, and are satisfied with what the speed brings. Even if it means that they miss so much on the way, they don't even see that. I see everything that they don't. From here, I see it all. Then, when the time comes, I make use of what I've seen. I can get whatever I want in this way. Anything at all.
Certainly talkative today, Harry. But I didn't come here for a business lecture. Tell me everything you know.
Speed is not important. Timing is what is important. Timing. have a natural gift for waiting for the correct timing.
Okay.
Just be careful that your haste does not ruin everything. That will be vital to solving the current case at hand. York, I know more than you think, but less than what you hope.
Sideline on police information.
That reminds me, the victim's tongues were cut out, weren't they? But that's only a minor point. Don't let the shocks blind you to what's more important. That's another business tip.
Harry, I'm impressed. You gather information really well. You hacked into the FBI network, too. Amazing. But I didn't come here to hear this.
Then let us close the business seminar. It's time for a history lesson instead. I remember it as though it were yesterday, if you'll pardon the cliche. It was dark.
Country.
inside. I tried, but was unable to suppress it. One word resonated through my head. Kill! 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 Without thinking, I took a branch and attacked the man in the raincoat. For a moment, I didn't know what was occurring. The face beneath the hood was that of my father. Expression I had never seen before. Hatred next. He clearly saw me, but that did not stop him from attacking me. He knocked me out, and I fell to the ground. The following morning, I awoke surrounded by dead bodies. It wasn't raining anymore.
And the how the hell did he get in? I thought that was, closed everything off.
And what I myself had done. But even worse things were waiting for me when I got home. My mother was dead. Killed, presumably, also by my father. The next day, the town was overrun by military personnel. That's when the gag order was issued. Talking about the incident was unappreciated, a taboo. But even still, people stopped going out. Country folk are very patriotic. We never tell our children about what happened. But these things find a way out of even the tightest of lips, in parts. People only speak of the killer in the red raincoat, which is where the legend of the raincoat killer comes from.
Quite a story.
After the incident, the gas seeped into the soil of the town. Even today, when it rains, a minute amount is released. That's why I never take my mask off when I'm outside. This town is dirty, York.
If what you say is true, then the killer is someone who is badly affected when it rains.
You need to draw the conclusions, not I. I have no conclusions.
Is there a connection between the red seeds and the gas, then?
This is just my own presumption. The seeds and the gas have a similar effect on our nervous systems. I believe someone figured that out and decided to use it. Or it could just be nature's way of getting back at us humans.
Ask you one thing then, Harry. You're a businessman. You must be after something in return for giving me this information.
York, at times we must purge things from this world because they should not exist.
But that still does not justify murder.
Remember this. Everything changes in form. There isn't a single thing that can maintain its shape.
Mm-hmm.
Look at that money.
Thomas.
Ah, he's at his house, right?
How did you know that?
Timing, Emily. Good timing.
Ugh, whatever, just get in. George is heading over there already. Let's get a move on.
Now is for Thomas to fill in the blanks in our new legend.
You know what? That sounds like a good point to stop. So, for those of you who are watching on Twitch and Blur, and YouTube, thank you all so much for watching. It was nice to get back into this. I'm still super goddamn confused. So confused about this game. So, I'm Blurry Phoenix. Game on.